गुड इवनिंग सर, हाउ आर यू?
गुड इवनिंग, आई एम फाइन, हाउ आर
थैंक यू
यू?
सो मच. आई एम गुड सर, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस टुडे इवनिंग. एंड आई एम सो ग्लैड एंड सो एक्साइटेड टू सी योर पिक्चर्स एंड यू टॉकिंग अबाउट देम. सो गाइज, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस टुडे इवनिंग. सो आई एम फर्स्ट गोइंग टू इंट्रोड्यूस सर लिटिल बिट, एंड देन ही कैन टॉक अबाउट हिज जर्नी ऑफ हिज लाइफ ऑन हाउ इट हाउ स्टार्टेड एंड हाउ थिंग्स गो ऑन. So sir, Ajayan sir has been working with the banker all his life, and then he got retired, and then he thought of doing something more in his life, and he was exploring a hobby, and then fortunately he found photography, and then he started doing things, and he did really well in a very short period of time. I can tell you he has done really well, and his pictures are now have been exhibited all around the world, and he has got a lot of award for his pictures. So that's very little I'm saying. Maybe sir will introduce now and talk about his life journey as a photographer, how it happened so far, and tell us about his success.
Thank you, Saurabh ji, calling me for this. I am feeling privileged. I am slightly nervous because you have been interacting with great photographers, and so it's a that's why when you called me, I was just slightly hesitant whether I can do justice to it. Anyhow, I feel privileged for being with you today because I had been, as you rightly said, I was a banker for quite a long time. I retired in almost 39 years. I retired in 2040. When I was about to retire, I was thinking what to do because I was staying with alone for almost 14 years. I was in Delhi, Bombay, Madras, and then came to Hyderabad. So I had to come back to my city, Kozhikode, where family is there, because I was staying, children were studying. So at that time, I was thinking what to do because I decided not to go for any job anymore. So at that time, one of my friends, Seshagiri Rao, he saw one of my images and he said, "You should go seriously into photography." Then he gave me his DSLR 7000. One day he came and kept it on my table, on my cabin. He said, "You use it, start using it." So that was a turning point. In fact, I started using it, and I thought I just determined let me have some time on this because I have been doing photography in my college days. I was in the camera club and all. So when I was about to come back from Hyderabad, just I heard about you. So then I had the opportunity to meet you, interact with you. The kind of guidance you gave me, I can't remember the motivations that you gave me, and I delayed my stay coming back for another 3 months to stay with you, to be with you, interact with you, to walk with you. And slightly, I am, though I could not do full justice to it, I still feel I have not produced any great pictures. But still, I feel I could, I enjoyed the journey so far. I was involved in lots of other activities also. I got entangled in so many other mentoring and management, presidentship activities and all. Now, I feel I want to spend more time in the photography and enjoy the sound of the click of the camera. That something gives you some kind of kick, like when I used to play cricket, when the leather hits the willow, the type of hit, the love you get out of it. So that's something which I enjoy, and very much thankful to you for introducing me to this and giving me the confidence that I was wondering whether at this age I can start a new hobby or redevelop my hobby, which I was doing, which I was not never doing for almost 30, 40 years, 42 years. So you gave me the confidence. Then I started some workshops. I went with APF workshop. I had the opportunity to meet Vinit Bora and Rohit Bora. I talked to them. I had a workshop with them. But you continued to be, I used to be in touch with you always. That's how I started my journey in photography. Yeah, it's 6 years since now, meeting you and taking up that journey.
Great, great. So I can't wait to go through your pictures and you telling us a little bit about the pictures. And in between, I will ask you a few questions related to some other stuff as well, right? So let me share my screen and you should be able to see the pictures. And it's amazing that you have done some work even during the lockdown. So maybe we'll start with your lockdown pictures, which is still going on. So Yeah, please tell us a little bit about how you took
Yeah,
things.
because during lockdown, I was wondering whether, because I was slightly surprised, it's a new normal. I was attending lots of webinars on new normal and all. I thought there's something that I should document at this point of time, whether I can do something. That's why I took my camera and started moving out of, moved out of my house, traveled. And I went to beach. There I saw it was a different place altogether, which always used to be highly crowded and all. So I revisited that place again once or twice again. Then I saw there are possibilities of taking some pictures, good images, which can I can document and I can keep it. Because so this is one image which I took from there, the structures over there, the sunset, the sea, and the lonely man walking over there. So something I was attracted to this. I took the photo, but ultimately it came the way I wanted. So this is one photo of that. And work on the COVID-19, that is, this was just before the lockdown was declared by Government of India. So there was a break the chain, which was introduced by Kerala government. So we were not allowed to, especially seniors, and we were not allowed to go to that beach and all. So I thought this is the right time. So this work on of mine, this is Break the Chain, Sunset at Kozhikode. This was published. I was lucky that it was published as a photo story in 121.com. It was one of.
Right,
Thank you very much.
right, right. Sir, can you mic hold the mic a little closer to your
Yeah,
mouth?
sure. Yeah.
Okay, great. So I can see your pictures have a lot of strong lines, and your compositions are such interesting and such intriguing. So how do you get this kind of composition? So do you visualize and then you wait for a moment? How do you do this?
It's right. I really like that because in this picture also, I like the stripes. I like that line. I waited for some time for the sun to be that place. And I was seeing that this person was not there. He was standing somewhere else, and he was taking, going around and seeing whether people are there or not. So I knew I waited for this man to come to that side. So when he came there, luckily I captured that image, and the movement also I got. His one foot was moving forward, so I could capture that movement also. The sea and all that line was also clear. Lucky. When I came back and looked at photo, I liked this photo very much, sir.
Beautiful, very nice. So your pictures also have very nice diagonal elements. In a lot of pictures I was seeing, I was watching them when you sent me. So very interesting lines you have in your pictures.
Here also the from the this is this was taken from the same beach the next day. As you rightly said, the pillars and the steps over there, the lines leading to that, even the line of the horizon is very clear. And that red shirt, the lonely person, that beach moving around, standing out. So I thought, I think when you say it's a good picture, I'm really happy. So I'm lucky, lucky to get that image.
Beautiful, very nice.
This is another image of the policeman moving over there. There's a sculpture, there's a work, artwork over there. The sunlight is there, the sunlight is beaming. So sometimes the light gives you lots of effect to your movie, your p images. So that even the light on the back of the policeman and the sea horizon and all, and the total background. I thought that it fits into that story of and story of that COVID era, how things are. Okay.
Right, very nice. So even this picture is quite interesting. The deserted beach and that lady within that bracket. So
No,
very
that's what
interesting.
I waited for that for a few minutes, whether she will come there. Luckily, she moved to that position. There was a possibility that she may move to the other side, but luckily
Right.
she moved to this side, and I got that image that with that sunshine on the sea and all. And I think, and that even that two trees, that truck, all those lines going up of that pillars, that frame, as well as that small. Small that vendors outlet and all. When you say it's a good photo, when I analyze, I think yes, it's a good something. It imaging. So if it's good, thank you.
Yeah, all very interesting. I particularly like your other series. I'm really waiting for those. Even this one is such a beautiful picture, that deserted beach with the crow, and really a very interesting picture.
Thank you.
So how much time have you been shooting in the beach? I mean, during the
So that
lockdown?
day it was slightly difficult because the police, they were not allowing me to get out of the car and hold on my camera. So I visited this place. It took 2 or 3 days for me to do that. To do this, I have taken some captured some features. But one policeman, when he knew that I am taking some images, he said he kept quiet and asked me to just move around. But he told me don't go to long distances and all. I was able to take this photo. Let me ask you one thing: what if that top line was in line with the horizon, the sea, and whether it would have looked good or not?
I will like it like this because there is separation between these two lines, so I definitely like it. So otherwise, overlapping probably, I think this
good.
Is a little better.
Good.
I absolutely like this series of yours. It's done very interesting. Please tell us a little bit about this.
This series which I have done is called Kerala. It is called as Vavubali during Karkadaga month, but it's all usually it falls in the August. There is a full new moon day, which we do some kind of Hindus do kind of worship for the dead our ancestors. So it's a very major event done throughout Kerala, and there's a place called in Varakkal in Calicut where this is happening. It will be crowded throughout the day, the morning and previous evening and the night, more next day morning. So this, in fact, this again was published in this 121.com as one of another photo story. And this photo was also published by National Geographic Traveler, both in their digital edition as well as they shared it in their Instagram, and which got very good response. So I was lucky to capture this image at that point of time. But in fact, this series of this has happened. These images I have taken in 3 years. Whatever has come in that photo story, it has come in 3 years. It is covered in 3 years because different images taken different times. Okay, right.
Great. Very nice.
Because I also thought, considering the theme, I should take it in, make it in black and white than color. So the black and white was more effective, match with the theme as well as it was more effective.
Right. So once you shot, after that you went two years after that as well. So why did you think you have to go to a place again and again?
Because I wanted to do that documentary properly, because I was not satisfied. Though I captured so many images, I wanted at least 10 to 12 images worth standing, so that I can develop a story and also to understand. Because the it lots of when you do a documentary, there are lots of things, the expressions of the person and the situation. You should be able to bring a good story from the beginning to the end. So I thought I had to do it. I waited for, because though I tried to I have posted these images, but the total work is of 3 years, taken in three, that is 2016 August, 17 August, and 19 August. Yeah, 3 months.
Okay. So, do you intend to shoot this in the coming years to come as well?
Yeah, basically, I posted some good photographers like you. I had shared this photo story with Barbara Davidson, that 2 times Pulitzer Award winner, through my Facebook link. She had gone through it and she really appreciated it. She told me you should work on this for another 1 or 2 years also. Try to bring more images on this, and it should be a serious work of yours. So I'm lucky. At least I get some tips from persons like you and people like this caliber. When she told that, I thought this year I wanted to do, because of COVID it was not possible.
Right. So next time if you go there, what do you think you will do differently, or what would you think that you will capture that you could not do in the last years?
At least at that time, next time I'll try to connect one person to this, at least one person from the beginning, and at least a story of what the relationship of that person for whom he is doing this. And I try to do something like that. If it is, I have not tried anything like that, so that the total mood and the journey of that particular person doing this throughout this process.
Okay. So how many, for this particular picture, how many shots did you take, and why did you choose this? I can see there is so much of synchronicity between all your subjects here.
Yeah. Because this basically was a single shot. It was not a continuous shot.
Okay.
This basically was a single shot. But what I missed out here now, if I tell you that, though the photo is good, there in such function there will be, usually you can see crows, some crows. So
right.
There was a moment before that, there was a crow just about that person who is standing in front. So
okay.
That moved out. So had I got it, the picture would have been slightly more different. Because
right.
I'm just
right.
telling you.
No, but still, this is quite a nice picture. Yeah. So from the same cities.
Yeah, this is they after doing that function, they carry all that and they throw it into the drop it in the sea. So they are moving after that from that area where they are doing the function. They are moving to the sea to do that. Yes. And all the steps and the legs and all those, I like that. So
beautiful.
I'm lucky. I got I've taken two or three.
Mm.
So this was the picture with the least overlapping. Because most of the individuals are stands independent, but still there are one or two. But this was better of all that.
Very nice.
And this is again from the same place. The activities, the policeman, the anxiety over there,
right.
And the vibrancy and the flow of that water and the sand. And the all that slightly cloudy movement, because this I think this was taken in a different year, and lots of actions over there, and the way the total structure, if you the human structure, it comes like a pyramid. So I liked it. So it gives, I think it gave more strength to the image.
Definitely, you know. And the chaos, and you see the expression of the people and that rising wave. So together,
yeah.
Makes it a really nice image.
Yeah. This is the same. The people are moving out. As I told you, this man was looking at me from the very beginning. So I loved this man, and it was so powerful, so penetrating. So I captured it, luckily I got it like that. That's good, because of that shadow also made that eye slightly more powerful. I was lucky to get that white of that eye, so that the image that image stands out.
Right.
You have to tell something on this, anything, any improvement on this, any correction?
No, I think this is very good. This is such a lovely image where she have made very nice use of the foreground.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
This is again from this in fact, I want to do this work again, because for this image I went to Trichur. This happens at Trichur, which is Pulikkali, tiger dance. This happens
right.
During Onam festival. So you also had, we had gone there once.
Yes,
so
yes.
Time. I went alone, but you see, I could take some pictures, but you cannot say it can be a documentary. It could have been a documentary had I gone there 2 days back and I had been with one person, studied there, what all things they are doing and their life part of it. But anyhow, I could get some of the pictures good, and especially the design that came in foreground, I liked it. And the person, the person with the tiger. So his expression and the way he stands, yes.
Beautiful. Very nice. So are you planning to go there again this year?
Yes. At this time,
year,
I don't know whether it's going to happen. If it's not happening,
maybe next year.
Next year.
Yeah.
We'll, I know, at least we should be there at least 2 days before.
Right.
Get the feel of the people, talk to them, feel the mood, get the mood.
Right.
Then also you also get into that mood. Then the photos will be definitely different.
Right, right. I love the way you have so many. I even like this eyes of the Kathakali statue here. So such, I
Yeah,
mean,
that's a
picture here. It's beautiful.
thank you.
Very nice.
Initially, I was thinking whether that is a distracting element. Later, I felt that it's good that the eyes should be there.
So it is just, you know, the more you see your images and you start seeing other images, so you see, you get idea of what is good and what is bad. So a lot of times I also go back to my old images and things that I thought were not very good, I find something interesting in them. And it can happen the vice versa as well. The things that I thought was a great image, maybe now I don't like that much. So it is always good to go back to your images once in a while and see them. Very nice. It's such a beautiful image. I also love the way you have included little bit of this head of the person. You can make out that somebody is
Yes,
painting. Such
yeah.
a beautiful picture. So again, you can see the synchronicity of the people, all the people, the way they are acting. So very multi-layered, beautiful picture.
All these were captured the same day, on one day.
Right, beautiful.
It was raining also on that day, that's it.
Right, so what kind of preparation do you do if you are going for a shoot like this?
Now, basically, like what you saw for that Bahubali and all these things, when you go there, at least you try to understand what is that festival, what are the activities, where all they move, how it works. And there are different locations where they do all this painting and all, make preparations, find out all those locations earlier and have a in-depth understanding of the process. And once you go there, basically, I think it will be better if I go there next time, because when the rhythm, the understanding the rhythm of this Pulikkali is very important, because
Right.
once you understand the rhythm, you know when the hands will move, at what position it will come. So it's very important, because that makes the picture totally different. That happens in Tira also. Unless you know the rhythm, how it is happening, how the unless you anticipate how they are going to move, then you get a preparedness of that. As even the hand also, it was when you said that, I also realized that how it has synchronized. So next time I go, maybe it will be better images.
Right. So, see, Kerala is a land of so many festivals. Okay, so every now and then something is happening.
Yeah.
Now because of COVID, it is all stopped. But so, do you plan to? Do you have you made a list of the festivals that you're going to cover?
Yeah, already is there.
Okay.
I can share that also. Yeah, this time I wanted to do it slightly more serious, because I am slightly free of other commitments which I decided not to.
Right.
So planning to go for this seriously, and Theyyam Thira, and also
Great, great.
I was in touch with a person who is actually he has written books on Thira, and you also mentioned about the girl lady who is can support on this. Maybe let's hope maybe next year things will be all right.
Right. I will surely would love to join you for a
Please,
few of them.
please, please.
Okay, so moving to the next image. Very interesting.
I like the expression of that person standing there, his eyes, the way he looks, and
Right.
in the even the stick he holds, it has a bend. He has also bent to one side, and so this person is looking at a different level, and the eyes of the tigers, that's also widespread. So I selected this photo for you. If it's good, if you have found it good, just happy.
Yes, it's really good. This is, I think, this was published in some international magazine, I
Yeah,
guess.
this was taken from Varanasi. This
Tulsi
was,
Ghat. Tulsi
yeah, the
Akhada.
same place. Yeah, this was published. This is the only book of my photograph of mine which was published in World Photography Book in 2015.
That's
They
amazing.
featured 105 photographers in that, because they took this photo especially because the concept of when I learned so many things, the layers, the first person and the second image, that hand, the movement of that hand gives strength to this photo. Had I used a slightly higher shutter speed, this effect would not have been there, because the
Right,
hands are
right.
moving, other things are still. So, and the third person also, that the layer effect has been good for this. And I was lucky that it was published. So when the very very senior person, he visited Calicut, and I had a sat with for a workshop with him. I showed this image which was published in that book along with the book. When I presented to him, he gave an autograph mentioning it's a powerful structure and composition. So then I
Right,
started again looking into it, the powerful structure,
right.
and at least lucky that I at least I could bring out one image which could at least a person of his caliber would appreciate. And
Absolutely.
not only that, he showed it to everybody who's sitting in that hall about this image.
Great, great. Very nice. It's again a very beautiful picture with such a strong vertical line across,
Yes.
cutting across the whole frame.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
So this was Varanasi.
This is again Varanasi, because there's a concept. We all think that's a place. I know. I don't know. I won't say we all. At least I was under the feeling it's a place of Hindus, where Hindus sit and worship and all that. But when I saw these Muslim brothers, I was slightly eager to know what they are doing. So I was standing there for some time looking at what they are doing, because they were actually looking at Mecca, that side, to that side, and they were doing their worship, and they were throwing food for the fish also over there. So I like that. When he turned his face to this side, I took this photo. So luckily for me, that man who was singing, he say, raised his hand at that point of time. It was luck that came to me at that point of time. And that strip, as you rightly said, connecting the boats, that man sleeping in that boat. So that's how the picture was structured. At least the movement for the swimming, that was not at all anticipated, but that the image came powerful only because of that movement, that particular person on that corner of the image. Which connects, and also the man. That's actually the image than these two persons sitting over here. But these images are also good, and the way they are looking at, and that's how it was developed.
Beautiful, very nice.
This is
Another,
again from Varanasi.
yeah, very interesting picture. The synchronicity of the hands is just
Yeah.
amazing. So you got it.
That's only I wanted that, because I was standing in the right close to this person, and they were going on doing bhajans. I was there for almost 35 minutes. So I was seeing this, I was listening to that also. Sometimes even without taking photos, you enjoy. As John Isaac was telling, there are lots of images which you have not taken, but you have seen. So that I was the moment that was image. So all of a sudden, it struck me that there's a synchronization happening. The hands of Shiva, Ganapati, and the Sarasvati over there, and all that. Why don't I get a capture an image on this? That's
Right,
how
right.
that's the image
Beautiful.
came there.
Beautiful. Very nice.
This is here is an interesting story about this person. You have time on that?
Yes, sir. Please tell
Yeah.
us.
So because this man particular was not allowing to anybody to take his images. I also tried to take his images. He was cursing me and all that. And I was standing there for some time. Then I observed that he wants money, to be very frank with you. So
Yeah.
I realized that. Then one Japanese team came there. Then he was shouting at them. Then I told them that if you give him something, at least that's why he's. Then gave him some money, some amount, and took his photo. Then after that, I become his agent. I was standing there for some time, telling all the tourists who come there, give him some money and take the photo. So then after that, he allowed me to sit a photo. My wife and myself sat there and took a photo with him. And somehow I was not happy with the images I'd got of this person. It was just plain straight images. So then I went top of a tower over there. And this again is that it's nothing, there's nothing religious or anything on that. What he's doing is he's calling somebody who has gone there from that place without giving him money after taking his photo. So that movement of the hand and the light on that sheets and all, somehow I like that I got that photo.
Beautiful, very nice. Very different photo because of the unique angle. Wow. I love the way you have this hand here. That is really making it look so much more
Yes,
interesting.
that's it, because I loved that image, because it is that, actually it is that hand that makes this picture something of, because this is only a circus that's happening on a street side circus. It was happening at Calicut Beach, so there was a problem. It was too dark also, but the light helped me, so it was done handheld. I took three or four images, but I thought this has come up. This is the better image because of the hand and all. You have anything to add on to this?
Beautiful. So, how do you decide to compose it like this, with the hand like that?
Because actually, when I took the photo, my focus was only on this particular person. Okay. When I was developing this image, I saw this hand. So I felt that initially that small connecting that line is no that thread was also not there visible, and I slightly made it slightly exposure I slightly increased that thread was there, and the hand also I like that color on the hand. I thought it will give more strength to this image, so I initially took a crop without this and then with this hand. So I like this with the hand.
Definitely, definitely, it makes a much better picture. Very nice, very different.
This
Very
is
interesting.
from just I was in the went to the Calicut this is a fruit market and a vegetable market. So I took some images from there, a few images, but I like these images because the front, it's again in layers. No, the person looking at me and the expression of the next person, and even that red colors at different places gives some kind of strength to this image. And not only that, I think that pyramid shape, also
Beautiful, beautiful.
pyramid
So
shape,
all.
and even and that's that initially I thought those electric poles are not are basically some kind of hindrance, but later I realized that fills that place and gives strength to this image.
Right. So all your pictures have very strong geometrical elements, which is very, very interesting. So when you go to a place like this, sir, so do you ask these people or you just go on shooting your way without asking anybody? What
No,
is your
because
approach?
initially when you go, they are very doubtful why here. They ask why you are. They are doubtful whether what's the purpose, whether I am a photographer for a media or I am trying to do some kind of reporting or whatever. So I'll say I am just a retired person. I have some lots of plenty of time, so I just came to take some photograph. Then they said, "It's good, sir. It is good." Than doing any politics or something, it is good. Then you become party that sometimes take photos. And sometimes they will ask you to take photos. I will take photos and show it to them. And but in between, you get some photos like this, which are real photos, which are the photos which I want to capture.
Very nice, beautiful. So, in a situation like this, do you go on clicking many shots, or you are just waiting for a right moment? So, what is your approach?
Because if I am taking where there are lots of action happening, whether it's for a very fast movement or something, I'll just make it in two or three frames at least, not to miss the moment. I just do it, to be very frank with you. But this was a single click,
Great, great,
single
great.
shot.
Very nice.
Because even now, just if you take back, if you back that last image, can you take that? Yeah. See, I don't know whether if I had one more image, one more second, this man on the left side, that middle, his hand is covered with this man's head. It would have been slightly up. It had a movement. It was slightly on the upper. It
Right.
was slightly above. I think
Right.
that would have created some more strength to this image if you look
Right.
into each
Right.
small
Yes.
element.
Yes. Right. Right. Yeah, this is another favorite picture of mine of your whole series. Beautiful image. I think we had this for your exhibition, for
exhibited
our
your place.
exhibition.
Yes.
Yeah. Beautiful. So please tell us a little bit about this image.
No, because this is a Pudiyappa harbor. I go there, used to go there. Once you came to Calicut, we went there, that place also. Taken
Yes,
some,
I
yeah,
remember.
taken some images from that place. And these people become very friendly with you. I wait so that they are on their own. Because even some of them even start talking to me and say, I will ask, you had come here last week also. And one person even offered me to take in their boat. I was capturing this. I saw lots of activities happening there. There are lots of lines, action, and the colors and all. So I took three or four images of this same. But this is the one which I got synchronized. All the four hands are synchronized on top. And in all the cases, you have the net on the top,
Yes.
totally down. So
Beautiful.
here I have taken four or five images of this and selected this out of that.
Right. Beautiful.
And
Beautiful.
the colors, different colors also
Yes,
making it
yeah.
different.
Beautiful. Yeah, there's another there's a very nice feeling about this picture. It's such a beautiful picture.
This was taken when I took my son and total load to Kapad Beach. So they
Okay.
went outside. I was sitting inside the car. I was thinking whether I should go out to take an image or not,
Okay.
whether it's not right time for me. Though I had not taken the camera cover for that, for the rain and all. So when they were there, then I stopped the wiper for some time. So I thought this is the right time to take a photo because all that foreground, background, and the sea and the bit of light coming in between through those trees. I thought this was also once made. There were two or three other photos also. One made cover photo of World Photography Group's their website cover photo. They made this as their cover photo.
Great,
Even
great.
here, I like the way the lights falling on that.
Yeah, beautiful.
Yeah.
So you carry your camera all the time with you, is it?
And most of the time, it may be there with me. My wife asks why you are always taking this. Sometimes let it be there. If I get a click, I will take a click. That's it.
Right. Very good. Yeah.
This was taken from. Again from Calicut Beach. I was not getting any images that day. The sky was also slightly plain. There was no drama happening over there and nothing was there. So I like that shy. When I was standing, I just, this is the line, that pillars and the horizon, that sea, that line, I found it in the same line. Then luckily for me, the people were moving around. I thought if I can get a couple of one person in between those pillars, it will be good. But my luck turned out to be like this. A mother and child came over there. They stood there. They were talking. So that's how I took this picture. Because if it had been in color, it would not have given it this impact. So because the sky was not that good that day, so I made it into a black and white image. That's it.
Beautiful, beautiful.
This is again.
One sec. Yeah, sorry. Yeah. Please tell us a little bit about this image.
This is again from Calicut Beach only. So I was waiting there for some images. At least evening, some people may come that day. Nothing was happening, and there was no drama in the sky also. But I saw one person moving around, and he was slightly, I don't know, he was thinking, and he was slightly sitting on some stone for some time, then going to say sitting somewhere else. I don't know whether he was waiting for somebody or not. Then I saw he sat there. Then I realized that there's a possibility of image with that pierce in coming into a pyramid shape, and to get that mat in front. And when I went behind him, somehow or other he bent his head also, which came good for me. So I took this image and made it into color. So because that pure that color, that mood was fitting. What I was feeling that he was slightly worried about, or he was slightly concerned about something, or he was depressed. So I thought, it's not that we want such moments, but still, when such a moment is there, if I can capture it, so I wanted to capture it properly. That's it.
Right, right, very nice. I absolutely love this image. It's such a beautiful image.
That's two couples, the sea, the vibrancy of the sea, the sky, some kind of white patches over there. And I was observing this this man was seriously going on telling this lady what is over there, that boat coming over there. But I was observing this lady was always looking at the young couples moving around over there.
Okay.
Maybe that she was coming from a village or something. She was moving around. She was not at all interested into what he is telling. So
okay.
I saw this moment. In this moment also, the same dark, both dark dress, and she looking at them, and this man showing him her where the sunset is going to happen, and the design of the umbrella also. Had
right.
it been black, it would not have given it this much of effect. And
right.
the sky also, the sea also gave. I think that's all how it happened.
Beautiful. So who are the photographers that you follow for your street photography?
No, I don't know whether I can fit into any kind of street photography or something, because it requires lots of skills and techniques and all. At least I if I can do some kind of documentary, as you have been telling, so that you evolve into something kind of you go with a theme and come out with some kind of work on doing that. So these are the things, because I came late into photography after 60 and all. I've not gone deep into studies, but there are some photographers whom I have seen. Maybe you are one of the first, and I try to follow almost all your trial photographs, see how you are doing it. And I also had the chance to work with Vinit Vora, Rohit Vora, and I've seen some of the where they do the posting. I see their photos.
Right.
APF also I follow in street, some photos I follow. And I was lucky I could at least attend three editions of India Photo Festival in Hyderabad. That gave me a real good opportunity to really to listen and see, interact with some greats like John Isaac, Russell Hurt, and Michael Robinson Chavez,
right.
Barbara Davidson, Rezar Dighati, and all these photographers. I've seen the work they have done. They are the photojournalists and that documentary photographers, how they have done even the war photos and the areas where the dangerous areas they have worked, gone where the terrorists they are, the photos they have taken. It was more of learning. I could, because I would say that more than taking photographs, I could interact with these people, understand how they take the photos, see their beautiful photos, images. And luckily, I am in touch with most of them. I don't trouble them. At least I follow their photos. Whenever there's a webinar they are doing, they inform me. I just listen to that and webinar. And when I do some work, sometimes I'll send a link to them, ask them to give some comments. Sometimes either Barbara or Michael, they make some comments to them. I feel it's really happy about it. That gives you some kind of motivation. And from India also, I could meet lots of photographers over there. Inderjit Kambai, I like photographers. Not that he's a street photographer or documentary photographer.
Yeah.
The way he
I love
captures
his pictures. Yeah.
Village and the village life, how he
yes,
captures.
Yeah.
I have told him I want to visit his village and see. And amazing. So that's a photograph which I often see his photos. And Vishwanathan Reddy, as you rightly you know him in Hyderabad, I could meet him. I'm in touch with him. And Rajan Babu, Raj Lakhwani, Amit Mehta, Abhishek Hajeka. Then I could meet lots of photographers through in Hyderabad. Whenever I get time, I go through it. I won't say that I'm a serious student of photography, but I don't know whether if I'll be happy if I can bring out at least 4 or 5 world-class photographs in another 4 or 5 years, which can
Why
really
not? Why
stand out.
not? Absolutely.
Good. These are some of the photographs I see whenever I get time. I attend to their webinars and some photography groups. I go, I see the photos. Sometimes I post also. That's how it's happening.
Great.
Then Peer Mohammed also used to help me whenever I have doubt, I have technical doubt, I call him. He's always available like you. He also guide me on technical things of photography. Yeah.
Great. Another beautiful image. This was also in Calicut.
This also image in Calicut. This image was very much appreciated by National Geographic. One editor was mentioning about the features of this that seller Venter. He is deep in thought in looking at something else, and the family, they are in a different world, and there's a
right.
wife and child looking at the wife and man looking at this Z, which is also dark. So they were telling it's a good image. So then I also started looking at it. So that's why I selected this photo for this presentation.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
And the colors also, I think it has come out well. All the colors you
Right.
have.
Yes. Yes.
And it's very difficult to capture such photos unless you know visual editing. I think I have to grow progress a lot on editing. Lots of good editing can make this photo more, more
Definitely.
appealing.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely. Beautiful.
This is sunset captured in Calicut Beach, near Calicut Beach. I was slightly unhappy about that. I could not capture the net as such, but I'm really happy how the water and the structure and the it has come. I like this image. Everybody, it was exhibited in one or two exhibitions, and it was also highly commented in some of the photography groups also.
Right. Beautiful.
And especially that hand, his hand, the way his hand, I have one more image where that his hand is not like this. Now that hand gives strength for this image. And his leg, if you, how it's standing also
right.
gives strength
right.
to this image. Beautiful. These are some of the finer elements that can add beauty, even though you are not aware of it, but it can give strength to your images.
Definitely, definitely. Yeah.
This is again Thira, but I have some more images on Thira. this is one Kandharana Thira, which I have taken very close to my house also.
Okay.
So I have taken some more pictures of this. I think I have one more better picture than this, but I like this, the way he's looking at it and taken it maybe I have taken it at 2 point. Very slow. It was too dark over there. I'm lucky because of that flames, I could get that image.
Okay. So guys, thank you so much for joining us today evening. We'll continue the session. And if you have any questions that you want to ask, sir, so sir will be very happy to answer your questions. So we'll take the question and answer session another 15-20 minutes. So in the meantime, just enjoy the pictures, and if you have any questions, you can just type in here. And we keep doing this program. So tomorrow also we have two sessions. So if you want to join in, please join. So you're most welcome to join. And if you want to get updated on the things that we are doing, so you might like to subscribe for the channel. So you see there will be a red button on the right hand side below. So so you can get the updates so that you enjoy having these sessions, and it'd be a great support for me as well. So sir, let us continue with the pictures. So how this Thira is different from Theyyam?
Thira and Theyyam are both ritual arts happening in the northern part of Kerala, which is Malabar. Theyyam happens beyond Vatagara. This happens Calicut and all, it is called Thira. Because Thira, it's more of movements. More of movements are there. Theyyam is more on the way they dress, the way they paint, the way it's very important. So these are the two different things. Both are done at the village family temples, and it happens only during between October, November to April. So it happens during night. It happens 3 or 4 days. And this man, this Kandaranathira, before doing this, he has to be very strict on his diet and all this for at least 1 or 2 months. And they follow that very strictly, and then only they do this.
Right. So this also happens all night.
Night only,
Okay.
yeah.
Very interesting. This is such a lovely picture.
This I went to a temple with my wife. I was parking my car, then I saw this image. So I told my wife, "You can move. I will stand here for some time." So I waited there for some time to see somebody moving coming out. So this lady came there. I captured that. Even the sari, the flow of that sari, that movement of the sari also gave strength to this image.
Yes,
And
definitely.
he's looking at that's totally synchronized.
Beautiful. It is looking like his knife is piercing through his through
Yes,
her
yes, yes.
whole body.
Yeah.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful. Very nice. I like the way the nose is visible. Little bit of the nose is visible, and the lady in the background. Beautiful.
That's mother-in-law sitting over there looking overlooking it.
Okay.
So I thought I should
Okay.
bring this
Yeah.
image. Here I've
Beautiful.
done some editing, but I think I should have better if I know editing better.
Yeah. So this is a lovely image. You see, you can see the difference in the body language of the mother-in-law and the wife. Yeah. Beautiful,
This
beautiful
was
image.
also again one of the selected by one of the photo National Geographic editors and commented
Beautiful.
on this.
Beautiful, beautiful. Very nice. So, did you ask when you were taking a picture like that, or you just go on
Yes, just
shooting
I
on your
told them
own?
I want to take it. I took it with the permission, but it is not maybe they were not aware that I'm taking this picture, but I was there for some time. So I waited for them to do, because they have to do that cooking also, isn't it? So
Right.
anyhow, they have to come to their natural settings, mood and all. So I went at that point of time. I got this that roti is there, and she was trying, the smoke is there, and the mother-in-law is waiting whether it's happening or not. And
Right.
that even the sunlight helped me with her nose and her face, and
Right.
came with
Beautiful.
that. So that's what sometimes see when you fall in love with light. And you know where to do that, gives you some amazing images. I'm not good at it, but still I want to. I love it, though. I'm sure I'm not good at it so far, but still, this is something which I want to capitalize and learn more,
Sure.
practice more.
Absolutely. Oh, there's a beautiful sky. This is so dramatic.
This is a Kovalam.
Okay.
So I wanted to get a foreground for this. I stood up on there was a small vendor table on that. I stood up on that, so I got that boat as in the foreground. Without that foreground, this picture would not have been this beautiful.
Right,
Even though the
right.
sky is playing dramatic,
Right.
what makes the image is that foreground, that light on that foreground boat, that sheet makes it good.
Right. Beautiful.
This is again from Kovalam.
Okay.
Again took this photo. It's just a photo that I took. I think likely they were very seriously talking about, and they were alone there, and this stream of water also connected with that.
Beautiful. This will also make a very nice black and white, I guess.
Yeah, I'll try that.
Yeah, lot of textures and lines there. This is a really beautiful portrait. I think it's really beautiful.
This was taken from Hyderabad when I came from IPF.
Okay.
This Vishendra Reddy, he was she asked her to stand near that and allowed us to take some images.
but I got a very good image, and that color and the light and everything was good. And one thing is that there was some light from the back also. That's why you have that hair, you slightly brownish, and you get that tint over there. So that made this image better. So it was in highly appreciated in one or two photography sites.
Right.
This is a pigeon flyer. What he does in Calicut, I don't know whether in Hyderabad or other place it is there. I think it is there in other place also. There are people, they train to fly the pigeons, and it fly for how long it flies, maybe for one day throughout the. So they train for that, and there are competitions happening for this.
Okay.
There are prizes for this also. Even small competitions, they get the 1 lakh prize and first prize and all. Mm-hmm. And this man was aiming for a bullet. He said, there's a prize competition coming up. If I win, I will get a bullet. And he was training. I was walking. This is the third day when I was going for morning walk. I stood a few days and saw him the way he's practicing and all. And one day I came those times I had the camera with me. I never took the photo. Then I told him one day, today I'll take you a photo. He agreed for that. So that's why it was COVID time. He was with the mask also. I was also with the mask.
Okay.
So when he was playing with this vision, I took this photo.
Great. Very nice.
This is again Tira.
Okay. So here, do you ask for permission when you're taking this picture, or you just
go around? Some people, they don't allow you to take the photos.
Okay.
And you have to respect lots of things. You should not walk with your chappals on into that area where they are doing it.
Right.
And you should not obstruct, because these are very kind of rhythmic movements, and the way they fast, and you cannot predict what's happening. So you should be familiar with what this kind of activity is, unless you go there, and very careful about it. And so they are also, unless they know you used to come here and you know about it, they won't allow you to get into that area, because from a long distance you can capture the photos. You want to close there, they have to go. And once these artists also, they also become very familiar to you. So they see you at one site, then they see you at some other site, and so they also cooperate that point of time. So, and they know I come for that, and they also know they will do a picture will be taken. So it's a natural process. So I get some good pictures because of that. And not only that, somehow I like this Tira, the movement, the rhythm, the music, and the atmosphere. It's very vibrant. Lots of things are happening. Even if you don't take pictures, the things that you see over there, the families, the children, the old people, and lots of activities happening. You have experienced it, isn't it?
Yes, absolutely. And it is mind-blowing. So what is your most favorite festival in Kerala?
Kerala, you see, now, because after coming to Calicut, I have been mostly capturing this Tira, Teyyam. Not done much of Tira, Teyyam. I have done maybe 10 to 15 Tira events, festivals I have covered, captured, and not gone beyond that. In fact, even some festivals, there are some rural, very, very rural religious festivals, which I also covered. So I like that more, because you see more life over there. The people are playing, their people and their faith. Because though I am not a great believer, but I like to see how they meticulously practice lots of things, and the instruments they use. I enjoy it, and taking photographs is only part of it.
Absolutely, absolutely. So you just have to enjoy that experience, and pictures are always a byproduct. Beautiful. Beautiful. Oh, one landscape picture at last.
This is from Valpara.
Okay.
So it's a tea garden. It's all tea estate, totally tea estates.
Right.
So I like that light, the way the light falls on the tea leaves and all. I loved that. Luckily, I don't know whether it's a good picture, but I liked it.
Yeah, it is nice. I like it, really. Okay. So Great. So these are the pictures that I had. It was really, I really enjoyed a lot going through your pictures, sir. So
Thank
now
you
we'll.
very much, sir, because I owe everything to you, because
Yeah.
the each time you go on telling that you can take pictures, I get motivated and really
Definitely, definitely.
yeah.
And you have had great success with your pictures, widely appreciated by everybody. So it's really great. So now we'll just go through a few questions that we have. And
Yeah, please. If I can
So,
answer, I am not an
yes,
expert in this
yeah.
anyhow, if I can answer. Okay,
Sure,
yeah.
absolutely. So Vivek sir is saying, excellent show shows how much one can do in normal situation with patience and creative ideas.
Oh, thank you very much.
Yeah.
It gives me
So,
more energy to take
yeah.
photos. I can continue. It makes me feel that I am on the right path.
Yeah, and your friend Seshagiri Rao sir is also here. He's saying hello to you. So,
He's the person
yeah.
who gave me, who dragged me into this, giving his camera to me.
Okay, great, 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 great. Very good. Yeah, so we have a lot of comments, a lot of appreciations, but I'm just looking for a few questions that I can answer. So Prakash sir is asking, some of your images are tightly cropped. So is it done intentionally?
Yeah, maybe that's what so this is something which has been told to me also. Even my daughter has told me once that some of your images are tightly cropped. The word she uses, it is very uncomfortable, because but I think that happens to be my style. Let me see if I can improve on that. Definitely, I look into it.
And Sudhir sir is asking, many images are shot with high ISO, but there are no grains in the images.
Because I'm using 750, isn't it? I'm using 750, and when you the when you when usually you don't get such grains. It's not a problem generally. It's not a problem generally. Yeah, I don't remove the grains. Definitely, I don't remove the grains.
Right, and
There are
sometimes.
situations when I really wanted the grains to be there to give more impact to that image, but it has not
Right,
happened. Yeah.
right. So in fact, in some of my images, I artificially add grain, especially for the black and white pictures. It makes it look much much better. And in fact, people who come from the film time, we naturally used to see a lot of grains in our pictures. So it kind of looks natural to see it like that. So Ambika is asking, do you use any filters?
I generally don't use filters, but I have one. That is what you only suggested, that polarizer I have. I generally don't use that.
Okay. Great, great.
I have that with me.
Okay, great. So I think there are a lot of comments. Maybe you can see them later when you replay it. And
Yeah.
yeah, so if any of your friends have missed the session, it is available in the same link. So the recorded version will be on YouTube. And tomorrow we have two sessions, two very, very interesting sessions. One is with Isaac Kimball. So he was the director of Bombay Naturalist Society. So very, very interesting session we are going to have tomorrow. And the one more session is there. So both are very, very interesting speakers. So I if you are interested in photography, you will definitely love to see them. Okay, so yeah. So the other is Meghna Sejpal, who is a wedding photographer from Gujarat, one of the first wedding photographers from Gujarat. So great. So thank you so much, sir, for joining us today. It
Thank you
was
very
great
much. I
talking
should
to
thank
you.
you, thank you, you for giving me an opportunity for this. It's a lifetime achievement for me, I would say. I'll treasure this moment, and I also should thank all those who helped me, my friends, my family, my children, who always supported me. Even whenever I go for and buy expensive gadgets, not something easy for a retired person to, but still, when I spend the money on that, and the way that they support, and Pir Mohammed sir and Akin Matthews, who the organizer of India Photo Festival, where I could get lots of opportunities to meet people, and many of the photographers
Right.
whom I could not mention. I love them and try to take some good photos that I will enjoy. Thank you.
Great, great. Thank you so much, sir. And I'll see you sometime soon when this
Please,
corona thing is
I want
over.
to do that. Yeah, please.
Oh, great. Thank you once again, sir. Good evening.